America, a nation founded on the values of liberty, opportunity, and justice for all.
And yet today, we deny these democratic values to millions of people.
America has 5% of the world's population, but holds 25% of the world's prison population, more than any other country in the world.
That's 2.2 million people behind bars.
This is mass incarceration, and it's not an evenly shared experience.
People of color make up 67% of those in jail or prison. Many of them are serving time for offenses that rarely result in arrests or incarceration for white people.
One in six black men have been incarcerated. If current trends continue, one in three black males born today can expect to spend some time in prison.
And it's not just men. Women are the fastest growing prison population, increasing at nearly double the rate of men since 1985. Most are incarcerated for drug offenses that are rooted in histories of untreated trauma and sexual abuse. Black women are only 13% of the female population, but they represent 30% of all incarcerated women in the U.S. This impacts millions of children, families, and communities nationwide.
How did we get here? For decades, tough-on-crime policies meant excessive sentencing and mandatory prison time for nonviolent crimes.
More than 70% of people in jail today are being held without a conviction because they can't afford to pay bail.
These policies disproportionately affect poor and minority populations.
Even short-term incarceration can have dire consequences. When they are in jail, people lose their jobs, their housing, even custody of their children. And too often, people who leave prison have little opportunity to start over because thousands of laws restrict the rights of people with felony convictions.
That's 636,000 people each year without access to jobs, housing, student loans, and other support for successful reentry into their communities. As a result, up to two-thirds of women and men released from prison are rearrested within 5 years.
All of this costs the United States $75 billion each year.
But the toll on our country and our democratic values is greater than the financial cost.
So, what if we choose to do things differently?
If we invest in expanding education and job opportunities for poor youth of color in ways that are proven to reduce crime.
If we change prosecution and bail practices to stop locking up poor people who are not a threat to public safety.
If we repeal excessive sentences and divert more people from prison altogether.
If we give people in prison education and job training so they have a fair chance when they are released.
If we create programs to support formerly incarcerated people and get rid of the legal barriers that make it difficult for them to rebuild their lives and their communities.
If we provide those with mental health issues or drug dependency access to proper care outside the criminal justice system,
then we can safely cut the prison population and create healthier and more prosperous communities. With your help, we can create a system that is both just and fair.
Join the movement to end mass incarceration.